Whitley May Football Club travelled to Thackley at the start of their FA Vars campaign in 2010. They were faced with a tough test against the West Yorkshire outfit, but a Paul Chow goal was enough to see them through to the third round. A packed Hillhead saw the visit of AFC Liverpool, and the spectators got their money's worth as the Bay romped to a 7-1 victory. The account was opened through Lee Kerr, who converted a spot kick after Paul Chow was brought down in the box. Chow put himself on the score sheet when he headed in from a Gareth Williams free kick in the second half, and the goals kept coming. Darren Timmins headed in from a David Pounder free kick. Chow once again hit the back of the net when he clipped the ball over the keeper before AFC Liverpool pulled one back from a superb strike from outside the box. Despite their best efforts, the visitors couldn't take any more of their chances, and there was more to come from Whitley Bay, as Kirk put the keeper under pressure and added another one to the home side's account. Paul Robinson made it 6 when he chipped the keeper, and Chow netted in his hat-trick to complete the 7-1 scoreline. Bay went on their travels to Herne Bay in the fourth round and opened the score through Paul Robinson. Paul Chow continued his goal-scoring spree in the FA Vars to help in the 2-1 victory. It was back to Hillheads for the fifth round against Dunstable Town, and the home side found themselves on the back foot. But it wasn't long before Bay were back in it through Lee Kerr. A Paul Chow strike allowed Bay to take the lead, and another 3 goals made it a comfortable victory for the Seahorses. Goals from Paul Robinson, a Kerr penalty, and a Chow header made the final score 5-1. In one of the most exciting fixtures of the Vars campaign, Whitley Bay were drawn against Northern League opponents Dunstan UTS, and again Bay found themselves 1-0 down to begin with. But the visitors turned the tie around and Paul Chow pulled one back for Bay. Both sides had opportunities to take the lead, but it was Chow who scored the winner, sending Whitley Bay through to the semi-finals of the FA Vars for the fourth year in a row. Whitley Bay made the long trip to Poole, where it again took for them to be a goal behind before they got into the game. But in the closing minutes, Damien Robson equalised, and then Lee Kerr scored a free kick that will be talked about by Whitley Bay supporters for years to come. In the return fixture, a huge crowd packed Hillheads to see if the dream of another trip to Wembley would become a reality. Poole did take the lead. But after the Chowie as a Donkey comments from the previous week from the Poole fans, there was only one man who was going to score a hat-trick and put Whitley Bay Football Club a place in the FA Vars final at Wembley for the third year in a row.